It's an orange juice.
What's up, everyone? It's OJ. So in our previous video with 500 Barley, we noticed he's insane in heist. Today, we're going to give some tips from the number one Barley in the world, me. No, it's olive oil. So he reached 1,000 trophies. 1,000 trophies with Barley last season. So here are some tips and strategies on how to use Barley to the highest caliber. When you play Barley, you want to be throwing bottles so that it lands half on the opponent and half on where they're going to be going. You really want to control the direction in which your opponent is going, similar to when you use Dynamite, but he's got that lingering poison puddle that deals damage per second that you can't really stand in. Your job as Barley is to keep the enemy pushed back if you're hitting a tank. Your goal is to damage them enough for your teammates to finish them off in a shot. If you have some tanks on their safe, it might be a good idea to use your special from a distance to not only deal damage, but also to protect your tank as well. Barley can force your opponent to run away into your poison or deal with your tank. Make pathing choices limited and difficult for your opponent. This specific heist map is crazy good for Barley. You'd be insane not to have Dynamite or Barley on your team when playing on this map. Just with his lingering poison attack, you can force your opponents into the corners, trapping them, and that gives you the opportunity to destroy them. You absolutely cannot let Barley live behind the tanks. They're gonna annihilate you. It's kind of like Clash Royale, where you have to take care of the support units behind the tanks, because that support's going to end up taking everything out. If you've got a tank on your tail, always throw the bottle in between yourself and him if there's some distance. This way, it'll kind of persuade him to get off your tracks and taper off. Like, get off me, get off my back. Try to find yourself barriers to run behind and play Ring Around the Rosie, because that's going to be your biggest advantage as a thrower. If the tank's within range and he's going to wreck you, you know he's going to rank you, especially like a Primo within melee range, you should be throwing it right under yourself to fully utilize your impact and burn damage. As Barley, you're able to deny Dynamite his safe area since you're both throwers. The difference being that Barley has more area denial and limits the space Dynamite can poison himself. In this case, Olive Oil trusted that his Leon could take care of the bull, and that the Leon trusted that Barley could take care of the Dynamite. It's all smooth communication and trust, especially considering that the Leon wouldn't have been able to take out that Dynamite anyways. Always be aware of who you're battling against and what their specials are. In this case, we've got a Crow, but sometimes you've got a Primo where their super can jump all over the map, across barriers, behind walls, and they're just gonna straight up assault you. You're not safe from these jumping brawlers, so always be aware of their yellow super ring and start really backing off, because you know a jump is coming, and prepare to defend yourself. If you get Barley's special off within two tiles of the heist box, it's gonna deal over 13,000 damage and take out 45% of the safe. If you see a Barley running in, kill him before he nukes your safe box. In Gem Grab, your main objective is to keep the enemy back and maintain the middle. Throwing bottles onto the gems is a very good strategy to deter them from retrieving gems. If someone dies on your team, then it's gonna be really hard to hold the line and you'll be forced to retreat back. If you use your special at maximum range, it'll be more spread apart, whereas if you're closer, it's gonna be a lot more concentrated. It's gonna deal 30,000 damage if they get hit by all of it. Both have different use cases. The widespread special will deny more space for less damage, where you'd want to use this in cases where you're trying to save your gem carrier, giving him more clearance from chasing enemies. You can also do this to their gem carrier and plant it behind them so that they can't retreat. Oh man, having a more concentrated special does a lot of damage in that area and should be used on heist boxes, or if a tank is all up your grill like Mortis. Look at this bear just get melted, get destroyed. That bear did not know what was coming, and it was just saved by their bell. Just like Dynamite, you'll want to keep yourself away from your enemies by having some sort of barrier to hide and throw behind. Scouting Barley is a lot more effective because of his constant area denial over time. He's got some splash and some time to look around, especially when he's throwing over those barriers. When you're playing against another max Dynamite, you'll want to throw it where you'll think he's going to jump and generally where his bombs are. That way you can get damage while he's waiting for his bombs to explode. Barley's attack with a star power heals him 200 health per bottle thrown. It doesn't matter if it hits any enemy. It's still gonna heal him, so you can stay a bit more aggressive if you have some cover. Keep in mind, his special does not heal, only his main attack. Overall, his playstyle is very similar to Dynamite in where you control the lanes, all three lanes, forward, front, back, all that stuff, and throw over the barriers. Dynamite and Barley even has the same movement speed, just that Barley has a stronger area denial a slightly weaker attack but a potentially stronger super. Barley's reload time is 2 seconds, whereas Dynamike's reload time is 1.7 seconds. So that was a lot to take in for Barley, especially from tips from a 1,000 player, but I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and maybe we'll even make a simplified tech video for Barley on everything else. Thanks for watching, and stay juicy.